Hey kids, it's Mark. I have had a really long, long day. Did a major clean in the house, decided to start fresh, start new, so I tossed out a ton of stuff. So I'm sitting in the middle of a mess waiting to organize it. So we're just gonna jump right into the questions. Winter, you asked us if we can trust somebody that does not like animals. First of all, let me tell you that when I meet you after giving you a big old hug, I will probably be wrestling on the ground with Dinky and Little Bear for a little while. Just love them to death. They're just so adorable. And I've known people that don't particularly like animals, and I trust them fully well. The only thing is, I don't know if I can actually trust somebody that would actively wish harm on an animal or another living thing. That's my big thing. I understand that just certain people just don't care for them, like, they're just not animal people. They don't feel comfortable around them. They make them kind of nervous. But all in all, as long as they're treat everybody well, I have no problem with that. Bob, you asked if we could get a second, if we need to have a second job and we could pick whatever second job it would be, what we would pick. Me, I would prefer to do something with the arts or something that is some kind of charity related that I have interest in or believe in. I would really love something with the arts, like glass blowing, glass art, glass design, or something artistic. Megan, I loved your answer for this one. I think it was really great when you mentioned Jim Henson's productions. I think that is a great idea. I would love to do that. Megan, you asked us what our favorite words are. Mine are plethora and myriad. I just love the way they sound. Guava Momulite, which is actually a hand-carved piece of decorative wooden fruit. I just always thought that was the neatest one. And diaphanous, which is kind of hard to describe. It's like sheer and translucent and airy, and it's DIAPHANOUS, I believe. So if you go to dictionary.com, you can get the exact definition on that one. Matthew, you asked what our zodiac sign was. I am a Cancer with a Leo rising, and if you know anything about the zodiac, I am exactly a perfect match and perfect blend of both the Cancer and Leo. I share both the certain traits, more of the emotional parts of the Cancer and the rambunctiousness and, I don't know, just the out there-ness of a Leo. Okay, and since Christmas is next week, and I was thinking that we should probably start phasing out questions, not really ask any new questions, and just finish out the week with maybe some questions that the viewers have asked me or PM'd me in general. Some of the questions I get in general and tend to be like, what goes on behind the scenes of the group channel? Is it really that hard to do a collaboration channel? What are the challenges of it? What have we learned from it? All that stuff, all that information. And also, the other question I was given was, if you were to sit on Santa's lap, what would you ask him for Christmas? So, I figure we could all just answer those questions, not ask any new ones, and then we'll do what we're gonna do for Christmas, so we can all spend time with our families or whatever we're gonna do with it, and relax and have some good times with that. And then we'll get back to questions or whatever we decide to do after that. So my input on the question about the whole collaboration channel thing is, yeah, it's a lot more work than I thought. You are committed to posting by certain times, and you have deadlines you have to do. You have to interact with everybody. You have to stay, try to give them something else to work off of. But the big thing is, you also have to make sure you're posted by a certain time to give the next person the proper amount of time to be able to do their video and upload it. And so it's a commitment, and it's not like having a personal channel where you just post whenever you want. You're committed to posting that video that day and that time. As for what goes on behind the scenes, there's a lot that goes on. We email each other, we text each other, we chat. Yes, we are really friends. Outside of this, we've gotten to know each other. We get to know each other more and more all the time. We talk about what different things that are going on in the channel and how we want to handle it. And I really consider them friends and family, and we've already passed 100 videos, and we have a good time with it, and we trust each other and can't wait to meet each other. So I've gotten a lot of the channel that I didn't expect. We stick by each other, and it's just amazing that you can get to know these people that you've never ever met before. Most of us have met doing the Pride video that Megan posted on her personal channel, and we all sent in information and she edited it, or sent in the videos and she edited it. And then we kind of picked up Winter along the way, which I'm so glad we did. We just generally like each other. And to answer your question, yes, it is true. To answer somebody's question, yes, it is true that we have never met each other in person. None of us have. And we do intend on trying to fix that. And we're working on that. Hopefully someday we'll all be able to be in the same spot. And God help the people around us, because we're probably going to be crazy asses. And as for what we would ask Santa for Christmas, first of all, I would love to be with my friends and family. I'm probably going to be alone for Christmas, so, well, no pity party or whatever. It just happens. I'm kind of used to it. I would actually ask that I would be able to spend it with my family and friends. And other than that, what I would ask is that Santa make sure that all my friends and family have a wonderful, wonderful holiday. So that is pretty much it for my video this week. I have to go back to organizing and straighten up the mess I've created by throwing away half the stuff that I own that was absolutely useless. And I thank everybody for their love and support over the past couple of weeks. And I hope everybody is well. And Winter, I will see you tomorrow. You all have a great week.